Reports are coming in this evening of electrical disturbance across the Midtown area of Manhattan, which may be a result of last week's storm.
What the fuck is happening?
It's not just us, this is everyone.
I put a spell on you.
Quite remarkable.
Because you're mine.
It's insane. It's really insane.
Stop the things you do.
I still have no idea how he did that.
What's up?
Oh my god.
I put a spell on you.
I'm just shocked, sorry.
Because you're mad. Mad. Oh, you're mad.
You can help me out on this side, and you can help me over this side.
Please don't tie yourself up.
Yeah, if you guys want to step back a little bit, that way you can see this. Not too tight, not too tight. Just step back a little bit, and a little bit, like that. Right, and basically, on the count of three, I want you both to pull it as tight as you can, yeah? On the count of three, yeah? So one, two, three.
Oh! Oh! No!
Yes!
No! Hold the rope, he said, pull it as tight as you can. And therefore, you know, just say.
No, it didn't go that way.
Yeah, it went through his stomach.
I can't make it through that.
Yo, I'm still shocked.
It was a boom, bow.
Wow.
He's gone.
He's gone.
New York, the city of dreams. It was mid-October, and I had landed in this vast metropolis for a three-week trip. Although I didn't know it yet, this journey would ultimately end in both tragedy and triumph. The city is an incredible sight, a concrete giant crackling with electricity. Skyscrapers soar into the clouds above, and over 8 million people scurry through its narrow streets like a huge colony of ants. But scratch beneath the surface, and you'll find something special. A place where magic really exists.
Oh my god! Is that drinkable?
I'm Dynamo. Nice to meet you.
Right.
And your name is?
Nate.
Uh-huh. I've got some cards here. I'm gonna give you a pen. Just touch the back of any card you want. This one right here, yeah? Just write your name nice and big on there. Everyone see that? Awesome. And then take the deck, push it in, and mix them up. I'll take the pen. Yeah, give him a shuffle. Yeah, he's done that before. Awesome. I don't want to touch the card yet. Can I borrow your hat?
Okay.
Is that cool, yeah? So we got Nate's hat. Let's see. Take the deck. You sign one card, you shuffle it back in there, right?
Oh my god.
One card on your hat. It's done.
That's crazy. That's crazy. That's wild.
Yeah, that's yours up.
Yo, that's wild.
Told me to sign a card. I signed it. I shuffled the deck. He took my hat, threw the cards up. This card ripped, landed on the hat. And it's the card I signed. It's crazy. That's crazy.
Hit it!
Harlem, New York.
Come on!
I first came to Harlem 6 years ago with legendary hip-hop group De La Soul, who were performing at the Apollo Theatre. The area is steeped in history and has hosted performances from music giants such as Michael Jackson and James Brown. Although a lot has changed since I first came here, I still love the energy of this place.
I'm Dynamo, your name is?
Chaz.
Chaz and?
Joel.
Joel, nice to meet you guys. I know we've only just met, but do any of you have any money I could borrow? I want to show you something cool. A dollar? Right. So, yeah, let's try this. I had travelled up to 155th Street on the edge of the Polo Towers housing projects. Upper Harlem feels worlds away from the affluence of Midtown Manhattan, and very few tourists ever venture into this neighbourhood. Booker Park basketball courts have hosted legends like Shaquille O'Neal and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. So I decided to have a game with some of the local kids.
Revelation. Sunshine. Ecstatic. Flaco. Standing in the sun, getting black as I want. You playing good then, that ain't backing me up. Skywalker, baby, ain't no dragging my hammer. Got a whole lot to say, so I ain't talking to them. I hear him eavesdropping and turn it up louder.
Come get me up, come get a picture, like, of this happening.
Oh, yeah, he's good. Even on the little finger as well. That's it.
I can draw.
Yeah, that's sick. Can I have a look at the ball? How often do you guys come out here and play?
Almost every day.
Almost every day, yeah? Back in England, we play kind of football, but it's different because you have American football, right? In fact, watch this. Oh! That's you, right? Who wants it?
Yo.
Oh, I'm playing tackle with it. We had an entry line corner. Yo.
He just squeezed it in. Like, he's
like, I don't see if it's bouncing.
It is, bro. Look.
Basketball
Word.
That we were shooting with, turned into a football
that you can throw. That ain't, that it ain't possible to push that shit back.
He transformed that shit somehow.
That's cool.
Yo, you can do my basketball?
Something out of a movie. It's crazy.
There's a hurricane brewing. In case you haven't heard, Hurricane Sandy is a Category 2 storm in the Bahamas. Last night, it roared through Cuba. The day before that, it hit Jamaica. It might come our way, say, Monday into Tuesday.
It's October 1st and a beautiful day.
Lots of sunshine today. A west or southwest breeze as we climb through.
Shoes for running, and I'll race ya. Sun is coming, it'll chase ya through this deadbeat town.
I was in New York for a three-week adventure, which would take me into the heart of this giant metropolis. As the autumn sun shone over the city, I headed down to Union Square in the heart of Manhattan, where skaters, professional chess players, and tourists congregate under the watchful eye of George Washington.
I'm Dynamo, your name is?
Caroline.
Caroline.
Hi, Patricia.
Christine.
Christine.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you all. Can I try something with your bottle? Do me a favour, make sure the lid's on tight.
It's sealed.
It's sealed, yeah? Okay, brilliant. I don't want to touch it, yeah, so...
Okay.
But I just want you to go and just place it over on the wall over there.
Okay.
Yeah, and just come back here where you were. And there's no way that from here I could do anything with the cap.
Right.
Or the bottle, right?
Right.
Just what's the cap?
Has an incredible mix of cultures, and there is nowhere that this is better reflected than in the city's music scene, which has given birth to some of the most iconic artists of the 20th century. I had headed down to Generation Records on the Lower East Side, which is a favourite hangout for NYC's record collectors.
I'm Dynamo, your name is?
Kyle.
Kyle, nice to meet you, Kyle.
Nice to meet you too.
Kyle, in this store, there's, what, hundreds if not thousands of records?
Yeah, I'd say so. There's quite a selection.
Quite a lot, yeah. I want to try something.
All right.
In a second, I want you to go and choose one record and just get it in your mind, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to know what it is, so I'm going to turn around. Okay. I just want you to walk around, flick through, find one you like, and then come tap me on the shoulder.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm turning around now.
Cool.
You go find one.
All right. You have forsaken all the love you taken, sleeping on a razor that's lower left to fall. I'm all set.
Okay, so you're thinking of a record, right?
Mm.
I'm gonna try and work out which one it is, but
all right.
I need you to help me a little bit.
Okay.
I just want you to show me which section your record's in.
All right, yeah, it's in this section over here.
Over here, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's in this general
this
area.
This section. Yes. All right, I like it, you're being big, you're not really giving it away to me. Hold your hand up. Take it, is that the one?
that is the one.
Take it out, check it out.
This is Gil Scott-Heron's Bridges album, yes.
I want to try something else.
All right.
Yeah, just come over here. I love all the artwork on the vinyls.
Absolutely, yeah, it's really cool stuff.
It's really cool. Could you just point to any vinyl that you see?
Point to anyone.
Anyone you want, yeah.
Okay. The one with the breast there, that's an interesting one.
So, yeah.
It's crazy. The album and all, it wasn't even just the case, it was the album and everything shifted spots right before my eyes up onto that shelf. And he was just holding it like this, shook it, and next thing I knew, they interchanged. It was just kind of just like blowing my mind right now.
Later that day, I headed to the Bolt clothing store on Frederick Douglass Boulevard. New York has some amazing independent clothing stores, and whenever I'm in town, I try to seek them out.
How you doing, sir?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. What's your name?
My name's Rashad.
Rashad? I'm Dynamo.
Pleasure to meet you, Dynamo.
There's, like, about 15 pairs of sneakers kind of in glass cabinets in the floor, right?
Yeah.
I want you just to pick your favourite pair. Just point to anyone.
Any pair?
Yeah.
All right, I won't pick a favourite. I'll pick a... Okay, I got one.
You got one? Just point to it.
Oh.
These ones right here?
Yeah.
Just come a little bit closer. I just want you to bend down with me. Just bend down. I want you to hold your hands out like this, almost above the sneakers.
Okay.
Imagine that you're holding the laces. Can you see the laces?
Yeah, I see.
Yeah? So imagine you turn a little bit and squeeze it, grip the laces tight. Grip them tight. Yeah? You got them?
Got them.
Watch. Now let go.
That's great. I have no words. That's insane. Sneaker on the floor, and he took my hands and kind of guided me to untie the laces. They floated in the air and untied themselves, it seemed like, from the floor. It was weird. It was something out of a movie.
As night fell, the temperature dropped dramatically, but despite the freezing weather, there were still plenty of people hanging out in the midtown area of the city.
How you doing, guys? You all right?
Hey, how you doing, man?
I'm from Dynamo. Nice to meet you all.
Hey, how are you?
How you doing? You all right?
Nice to meet you, man.
How are you doing? Are you cool? I'm going to give you some dollars. All right, take those. I want you just to pop in the store and just buy any magazine or, like, newspaper. Just dive in there and get one quickly, yeah? Wow. You got one? You got one, yeah? Okay, cool. Just pop it down there. I don't want to touch it.
All right.
Perfect. How many pages would you say roughly is in there, just from looking at it? Maybe 100, 150?
Yeah, probably 100 or something.
About 100?
Yeah.
Okay, just think of any page number right now. Got it? Look at me.
Oh. Like, man,
okay.
What page number was you thinking of?
20.
20. Check, what page is that right there?
That's definitely 20.
That is 20.
Can I try one more thing?
Yeah.
I want you to think of a time.
Gotcha.
Yeah, you got a time in mind?
Gotcha.
And then just take this Sharpie, and I want you to write down here, write down the time, and then sign it. I'll hold it for you earlier.
All right.
Let's see. Yeah, just down here, yeah. Perfect. Nice and big. So what time was you thinking of? 10:10. Yeah? And you signed it right there?
Yeah.
Right? What time does it actually say? It says
7:25?
Yeah. 10:10, yeah? 7:25.
Do not just change.
No!
On the page.
What?
What?
Yo.
10:10, look.
Yo, and it's
what? Yo, man.
Get the hell out of here. Don't change nothing for me. Time stands still for me.
Did you see this shit?
Yo.
Yeah, right, yo, stop playing.
Yo.
Yeah. That's insane. Yeah. That's absolutely insane.
That's a puzzle, right?
We're continuing to track Hurricane Sandy as that massive storm churns up the East Coast, and it's still headed our way.
Saturday, the 27th of October, as Hurricane Sandy loomed about 350 miles off the east coast of New York, in downtown Manhattan, the city was getting ready for a scary event of a very different nature. Halloween weekend. Pumpkins, witches, and candy. Lots of candy.
How are you doing, you all right? What's your name?
Anna.
Anna?
Hey, I'm Charlie.
Charlie? Esther. I'm Dynamo. So what we're going to do is I want to get a good mixture of all of them. In fact, here we are. 49 flavoured Jelly Belly assortment right here. Do you want to help me?
Yeah.
Can you just, I think you just pull it. I want to get it full to the top, so.
Oh, that's a lot. Just pull it out.
Yeah. Here you go, just two times.
That's good.
There we go. Yeah.
All right.
Do you see that? Got a good assortment there. Okay, now, Anna, I want you just to point to any one colour.
All right, blueberry.
This one right here?
Yeah, right there.
Oh, what? Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Just put your hands together.
Real jelly beans, authentic jelly beans.
That's good.
He asked Anna to choose one color, and I think you choose blue.
Blueberry.
Blueberry. And then he took the cup with all the different jelly beans, put it on the ground, and in one swift move, it turned all blue. And then he poured them out, and they were all blue, and the cup was empty. I couldn't believe it.
And then we could eat them too, so like.
Yeah, they're real. They're like not rocks or anything.
I'm Vivian Lee with a New York 1 Minute. With Sandy back to hurricane strength, powerful weather is beginning to hit the East Coast, heading in our direction too.
That afternoon, I headed out to Coney Island, which now stood directly in Sandy's path. Somewhere out to sea, the gigantic storm was making its way towards us. The amazing thing about New Yorkers is that no matter what life throws at them, they always come together in the face of adversity. And today was no exception.
I'm Dynamo. I want you to help me out, sir. Here's a dollar.
Oh,
I want you to stick it in the Zoltar machine.
Okay.
And I want you to get a fortune card out. But I don't want you to read the card.
You want me to read it?
I don't want you to read it yet. I want you to hold it between your hands like this.
Okay.
Yeah? So when it comes out, put it between your hands like this.
All right, sir.
Zoltar is here to give you the wisdom of the ancients. Do with it what you will. Destiny is not a matter of chance. It is a matter of choice. Create your destiny wisely, my friend, and surrender a bit more wealth for more instruction from Zoltar.
Don't read it yet.
Don't look at it.
Now, what I'd like you to do is think of any place in the world that you'd like to visit in the future. Just get that place locked into your mind.
Uh-huh.
You got a place?
Yeah.
Name the place out loud.
Egypt.
Egypt. I want you to have a look at the fortune that you just got. Have a read of it and read it out loud.
All right. Recently, you have had to make some judgments as others may be judging you. A wise man makes his own decisions. An arrogant man follows the public opinion. A mountain is composed of the grains of the earth. The ocean is made up of tiny drops of water. The more we judge, the less we love. Patience and thought will show you the right way. One last thought. Good fortune can be found in Egypt.
Oh my gosh.
We're going to Egypt. We're going to Egypt. What do we do? That's amazing. That's what it says. How did it know?
Oh my gosh. Are you serious? It doesn't
say that. It says Egypt right there.
Oh my gosh.
That's impossible, right? He gave me a dollar to put into the Zoltar machine there, and he told me, you know, take the ticket. And then after I got the ticket, he asked me what place would I want to visit in the future. And then he's like, okay, read the fortune. And I'm reading through, and it says, one last thought, good fortune can be found in Egypt. And that's really cool, so that's like random.
As darkness fell, Coney Island closed its doors for the last time before the evacuation and braced itself for the inevitable onslaught, which was now only a day away. I decided to head back to Midtown Manhattan, where Halloween revelers were making the most of their last day before the city was shut down. Although tonight was a celebration, I knew that many New Yorkers would be stocking up on household goods the following day, so I wanted to try something with that in mind.
We'll try something a little bit different, yeah? What's your name, sir?
Clarence.
Clarence, I'm Dynamo. Nice to meet you. Clarence, I need you to help me out. Yeah? So, first off, I need to get a napkin. Where's it gone? Excuse me, sir. Do you have any napkins? Just gonna get one of these. So we've got a napkin. I'm gonna give you that. Also, gonna give you a pen. And what I'd like you to do is first think of any household object. Don't say it out loud. In the middle of a napkin, just try and draw a picture of that object, yeah? I'm gonna stand over here so I can't see what you're drawing, yeah? And when you've finished drawing it, can you screw it up into a ball so that I can't see it? Yeah? Okay, just let me know when you've done that. You done that?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll come back in now. All right. Just try and visualize the object, yeah, and say it over and over in your mind, the name of it, over and over in your mind. A light bulb. Hold your hand up. And just try and visualize that light bulb. Yeah, everyone try and visualize the light bulb. Watch. Did you hear that? Hear that, look. Look. I smashed it.
You smashed it?
Yeah, yeah.
Look.
That, like...
Wow. In the midst of crumbling my paper, I saw a flashing light, and then it just destroyed my light bulb. I'm still at a loss of words.
Sunday, the 28th of October. With a gigantic storm less than a day away, the sky above New York began to change as the dark clouds rolled in. I headed to Katz Delicatessen on Houston Street, one of the oldest and most famous delis in the city.
Yadi and
Belsey.
Pleasure. Can I try something with this cup?
Definitely.
So I'm going to place it underneath the table. Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-huh. Just point to a spot somewhere in the middle of the table. Right there.
Yes, right okay. There.
Can I use this coffee?
Yeah, go ahead. Got it. Come.
Right. Yeah, just move your finger. So this spot right here. Watch. What's the coffee? Yeah, is that hot?
Yeah, it's warm.
It's warm, right?
Holy. Wow, you are amazing.
I am like in shock.
You're amazing. You're amazing. That's awesome. Holy smokes. Holy smokes. That's awesome.
Thank you.
Wow. No way. Well,
shit. I wonder if this is still drinkable.
These were empty, and he put it under the table.
And as he twirled it, it was just...
It would go down.
Know, like
it emptied out.
In this cup, and all of a sudden, he went like this, and it was all there.
There isn't a hole or anything down here, you know? It's like solid. And all of a sudden, it's just gone.
Good afternoon, and Sandy is closing in on the New Jersey coastline, only about 100 miles to go. And here's what it looks like on the satellite shot. Big storm.
To stay inside as much as possible after sunset tonight.
So it's Monday afternoon, the storm's getting closer and closer. A few blocks up the street, apparently, it's 60 mile an hour winds.
Someone told me long ago, never come before the storm. I know it's been coming for some time.
Buying tarps,
twist ties,
a pump, and some batteries.
Outside are dangerous and they're only going to get worse in the hours ahead.
The fire department is now on the scene of a crane collapse in Midtown.
Time for evacuation is over.
Dean, what's going on out there?
An explosion at a Con Ed plant on 14th Street.
A Ford Explorer just floated down the street.
Oh my God, we gotta get out of here because now the water's coming in.
Came, the severe and widespread damage from Hurricane Sandy was painfully clear.
It's like an apocalypse or something.
The next day, New York woke up to an alien landscape, ravaged by one of the worst storms to hit North America.
It's been absolute devastation here. So many people lost their homes.
For a brief moment, it felt like one of the most energized cities in the world had just stopped. But like it's always done in the past, New York pulled itself together, and soon the rebuild was fully underway.
I thought I had it all together, but I was...
By Sunday, we'll have electricity back downtown.
Within hours, setups like this one popped up. Crews handed out food packs, water, and blankets.
Lots of people on the streets now. Cars are moving. New York City's getting back to its normal self.
It was almost time for me to leave the US and head home. This had been a journey I'd never forget. From Queens to Harlem. Midtown Manhattan to Coney Island. I'd found magic in the most unlikely places, and the people of New York had shown me why this is one of the greatest cities on Earth. The events of the past few weeks had shown me how important it is for people to stay connected with each other. This planet is only a speck of dust, floating amongst 100 billion galaxies. So in the big scheme of things, we're all next door neighbours. For many people, the storm had wiped out their only means of communication, leaving them cut off and isolated. So as I headed down to Times Square for my last night, I wanted to see if it would be possible, if only for a minute, to create a connection between everybody in one of the most iconic places in the world.
So I want to try something with two people. These two right here?
Yes, come on.
Would you
mind
helping out? Would you help out? What's your name? Maria?
And Julian.
Julian and Maria. Everyone, Julian and Maria?
Julian and Maria! That's right!
Julian, would you stand back a little bit? And then if you stand right there. And
Are you two boyfriend and girlfriend? How long have you been together? 6 months. Do you have your mobile phones with you? Could you reach in and just get them out? And then just hold them up like this? Perfect. Like this, right? I'm gonna ask you to look at each other in the eyes and really focus, so really focus on one another, yeah? So if you wanna do that now, watch.
She was calling me and did not hit no calls or nothing.
At all.
This is my
phone.
Yeah,
this is my phone.
This time, I want all of you guys to get your phones out.
Oh, no.
Just hold them
Whoa.
Hey, everyone, get your phones out. Everyone, get your phones out, yeah? I need you all to just focus.
New Dynamo Magician Impossible will be calling back next Thursday night at 9. Next on Watch, a show like no other. Try not to look away. Danger Man, the incredible Mr. Goodwin.